All right. Thank you very much, everybody. And now I present the queen of all thrones. Stand up for Oprah Winfrey.
Thank you. As you can see, tonight is a party. Whoa. It's a celebration of the most successful broadcast medium in the world, television. And this, you know what it is, it's an Emmy, and it's the most coveted television accolade on the planet. And yet, it's impossible to win one. Almost. There are 8 billion people on this planet, but only 25 Emmys to be given out tonight. So your chances of winning? 300 million to one. So how do you win one? It starts with a dream strong enough to endure the knockdowns and the rejections, because you can lose a role or lose a whole series, but there's one thing you can never lose, and that's the belief in yourself. And without that belief, you will never succeed, and even with it, you've got at best an outside chance. So every nominee, every Emmy nominee tonight has been knocked down at some point, but you got back up. And that's why you're here. Voted for by your peers as the very best. So let's make some dreams come true tonight. Here are the nominees for lead actor in a limited anthology or anthology series or movie.
Colin Firth, The Staircase.
We stick together and we love each other.
Andrew Garfield, Under the Banner of Heaven.
If I were you, I would rather find that kind of family dead.
Oscar Isaac, Scenes from a Marriage.
We've gone through all of the angles and figured out where we went wrong and how we can fix it.
Michael Keaton, Dopesick.
I can't believe how many of them are dead now.
Himesh Patel, Station 11.
I always spent time with my mom. Where she died.
Sebastian Stan, Pam and Tommy.
Do you have any idea what you put that long, kind, sweet woman through?
Goes to Michael Keaton, Dopesick!
You got about 90 of these, don't you? I have to tell you, first of all, my face hurts so much from all the fake smiling I've been doing. Thanks to the great folks at Disney and Hulu and everybody at that table and everybody, this is really one of the special projects I've ever worked on, and it means something. So thanks a lot. It's just wonderful. I'm very, very grateful. I'm a little kid, very, very small. My dad wins something at a raffle, and he brings it home. And it's a little black and white TV, literally about that big. And we kind of lived out in the country, and sometimes people, neighbors would come down and actually watch it. When I saw this thing, this was my face from age maybe 5 to 10. And I could not take my eyes off it. It was magic. And I watched all of the cowboy shows and all the, especially the comedies and all the gangster shows, and I fell in love with it. And I would go and I would reenact these scenes or create my own scenes. And my parents and my brothers and sisters would watch me out the window. And to this day, they were never demeaning. They were never dismissive. They never looked down upon it. They never made fun of me. And in fact, they would ask me to reenact scenes for them. My folks weren't exactly patrons of the arts. We weren't patrons of anything, frankly. But I want to thank them. I just want to thank all those people in my family for never making me feel foolish, because I went on to do that several times myself. And that's the thing about feeling foolish and making a fool of yourself and making mistakes. There's huge power and merit in that. And I'm glad I've made a fool of myself over and over and over again. And one more thing I want to say. Over the years, we've all been through a lot of tough times. There have been some doubters. I've had some doubters. You know what? We're cool. But I also had those people for all these years when the times are rough who were the true believers. I fucking love you, man.